there is a difference between each country. The problem is remembering what it is.
A lot of times you don't remember the show, but you remember the place.
But I've just been overwhelmed with all the different territories that we've been going to in the world.
It's like you don't know quite what to expect.
When you plan them, they're really adventures, you know.
You never quite know what's going to happen. You never know who the audience is going to be. You don't know if there's even going to be an audience.
Once you're up there, it's its own country. You just do the show.
It is very unusual for this particular rock and roll band or anyone to do what the Stones are doing for us tonight, to fight global warming.
They speak to a lot of generations, they speak to a lot of different cultures, and that's precisely what we need to do in order to get a handle on global warming.
And when I was told that the Stones were going to do this concert, but they wanted me to introduce them, I was flattered and honored and thrilled to come.
Well, I'd like to thank you very, very much, everyone, for coming here. I know some of you have paid, you know, $5,000 a seat tonight to be here. Some of you have paid nothing.
We wanted to do the show. They wanted to do it for free. They wanted, you know, no one to pay to come in. And they asked us to do the show to raise awareness. We raise awareness for these environmental issues, awareness for the NRDC.
There are certain things that we do because we just feel it's right, and also that we're together.
Yeah, it was good. That's Clinton one, and he came along, didn't he? Rent a guest.
I'm here because the Stones aren't term limited and they're just as old as I am.
There's something out there that needs to be addressed. We'll do it. You know, we do lots of things that people don't know about.
But you know something? We're all doing the same thing. We're putting the spotlight in a very good cause, and you can all feel really good about yourself tonight, I think, with that, you know?
Well, it's nice to do something for the planet, you know, and we've got to put back, you know, keep taking out all the time. It's nice to remind people we've got to put something back.
There are things you can do. You can buy cars that use clean fuel.
The hybrid car, which I drove for a few blocks, it felt fine. For a few blocks, I don't know if I'm going to drive to San Francisco in it. We'll see. I'll give it a whirl.
It's whatever we do, you know, it's going to make a difference.
So when you leave here tonight, remember, even though the Stones once said it's only rock and roll, tonight it's way more than rock and roll. Ladies and gentlemen, the greatest rock and roll band in the whole world ever, the Rolling Stones.
Welcome, Mick Jagger. 昨日ドカンとジャンボジェット機をチャーターして日本にやってきたのはあのローリングストーンズ。
We're going to play in the Budokan, which is smaller and a favourite venue for people, I know.
Mata Tokyo ni korete urashi. Hashimeto no Budokan wa ikubun.
Well, I think the thing about the Budokan was that, you know, it's a kind of famous place to play a gig. It's a lot of rock gigs played there. It's a traditional rock gig place, and we'd never done it. We'd been in Japan a few times, and we'd never done the Budokan.
I found out after the show that it was the first time the Stones had ever done it, or I found out at soundcheck, you know, because I thought, yeah, the Stones must have done Budokan.
That was our first theatre show ever, and that was a special show, and it was cool, yeah.
Thank you very much. It's nice to be in the Budokan, you know. It's nice to be anywhere.
The thing with the Budokan was that it was the first time we'd seen the audience without any barriers and everything, and just all mixed up. And they were very, very young, really.
We saw the banishment of the tiny little red piece of gauze that flitted across the crowd barrier. They never crossed it. They would go, oh, mad, just behind it.
After every song, and then you did another song, and it was...
Because they always stay behind these invisible lines, because that's just the way they are.
But now, they just go crazy.
They were standing up and going, oh, it's okay.
And then create aisles, there was nothing. It was the lack of security I've ever seen in any kind of those gigs.
I need you, I need you, yeah, I need you.
We go there to educate them, that it's okay to have a good time, you know, and actually they're a great crowd. I mean, you just got to say, come on, it's okay, you can express yourself a little more. And in a way, you've got to show them how.
Yeah.
It's a good place to start the first gig we've ever done in India. This is a good place, man.
Well, never having played there before, there's that sort of anticipation and the unexpected.
It looks like playing the Wheelie Festival. I'm expecting like to be on with the Faces.
It's so big and so many people. Well, it's a different sea of faces. You could see them very clearly, you know, it's a different look.
And also interesting everywhere, there are a lot of young people about.
Bangalore, it had to rain, right?
Bangalore, I mean, it drenched. I mean, it was a thunderstorm.
Hey, the weather was never this good in Glastonbury.
It's just to keep the dust down.
Yeah, it's poured with rain, and we were filming. It's a bit of a mess.
Sometimes it's sleet, sometimes it's wind, sometimes it's heat, because God joins the band. You know? This guy comes in and he doesn't rehearse. You know, he just throws shit at you, you know?
Most audiences respond to that. They love it somehow. Because you're all getting wet together, I suppose.
I mean, if you run away and hide under an umbrella or, you know, call it off, it don't make it, you know what I mean? Hey, here it is, this is what we came for, and we all take it together, and it's cool like that.
Camaraderie with the audience is, I think, is the thing, yeah, because you're all in the rain together, except for Charlie, who's covered up.
My tendency is to go like a snail, you know, inside the shell and sit nice, but they blossom in it.
Hey, once you're wet, you're wet.
It was burning back a lot. Ow! It was ow! 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 Ow!
Dancing was out of the question. It was wiggling about, wave your arms a lot. Had to pass for dancing.
It's a little more difficult to play guitar, you know, when you watch the skid marks coming off and this. You feel like you're playing underwater.
You know those little things you walk through the swimming pool and you have to walk through to clean your feet? It's a bit like that on stage. Like 3 inches of water. Like, oh, what?
Keith and Mick particularly are fantastic in the rain, actually.
Some of the most, you know, intense shows have been, you know, in those kind of conditions.
She said so softly. Willkommen in Circus Krona.
And I'll leave something on here tonight.
Well, we haven't played in here, this place, for a very, very long time. You know, years and years and years ago, before I was born, we played here.
It's only been 38 years.
I must say, I don't remember anything about playing the Circus Krona.
This is only a circus. But the show of the Rolling Stones was the first great beat concert. And after this, all the managers came to make beat concerts in the Circus Krona.
Just because the room's so unique.
Well, we love playing those different clubs, especially ones with history like the Circus Krona. It's such a lovely building.
The nature of the building, basically, is like some version of Valhalla, really, isn't it? Is that there's oak. And the heat rises, so the audience are actually hotter than we are.
I think this is the hottest one yet, don't you think?
There seemed to be some sort of competition in this tour about the hottest shows, because we had so many hot ones. And all those indoor little shows have been boiling.
It was hot, hot, hot.
The hotter it is, the more sweaty and rock and roll it gets.
But, you know, it was one of the hottest gigs I've ever played.
So much sweat flying around that you're gonna miss a few notes in there anyway, you know, because the things, like, it's like surfing.
Some of the things that go wrong make it work, but not everything.
God, we can screw up better than anybody on stage, and most times people don't even know it. And
that's what they call spontaneous.
Purely impromptu, it's not planned.
Charlie's gonna do a song for you in a minute.
Thank you very much.
I've done that lots of times, a long time ago.
On behalf of the band,
bunch of bastards. Hey, bless your hearts, you know what I'm saying?
Thank you very much, Billy. You've had a great time. We did 3 shows. Thank you very much. It's been great. Good night, everybody. Good night. Hola, Madrid. Eh?
Muchas gracias.
Nos gusta estar de vuelta.
It's good to be back. Especially the cauldron, huh? Yeah.
They don't call it the quadrant for nothing in Madrid, you know. I mean, it's red hot in the afternoon.
So really hot. That was a heat wave.
Is the audience going to come up slightly half-baked by the time you get to them?
But it was a great gig.
It was a great audience there, wasn't it? I mean, it's fantastic.
You know, the Spanish audience is incredible amount of energy.
To Barcelona.
People turned out in the streets as we were arriving in darkened windowed vans. It didn't matter. But the people just came out of shops. They came out of buildings in a way that they don't normally do.
Barcelona is fantástica, eh?
Catalan, all right.
They do that like they do in Argentina. Right?
Ole, 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 chant.
Yeah, it was like Argentina again, wasn't it?
You're nuts.
It makes you realise when you play South America where ole, 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 ole really comes from.
Muchas gracias. I have a show to do.
Very reminiscent of Buenos Aires and Argentina and the South American ole, 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 you know.
All three of those Spanish gigs are fantastic.